guys, Becky here with Design Bundles, and I'm super excited to have you join me today, as we have a really awesome Cricut Joy tutorial for you. I'm here to show you how to etch glass the easy way using glass etched vinyl. All right, guys, so here we are in Cricut Design Space, and I'm super duper excited to show you just how easy this is. I'm gonna let you in on a little secret in case you didn't know already. When we are glass etching the easy way, we are actually applying a glass etched look decal. Okay, so we're gonna set it up and cut it just like we would adhesive vinyl, but it's a special look of adhesive vinyl that is translucent, and it makes it look like the glass has been etched. So super great and super easy. So the first thing we need to do is bring in a file. We're gonna go to upload, upload image, browse, and we're gonna go to our downloads, and we're going to say, after school snack cut file, and bring in the SVG format. Now when it comes in, we don't need to make any modifications, so we're gonna click on it and choose insert. Now I have already measured our wine glass, and we need to, well, first I'm gonna go ahead and attach it together. Just get that out of the way. We're gonna attach it. And then I know that my decal does not need to be any larger on any dimension than 3 inches. So I'm going to choose my largest dimension, which is this 19, and I'm just going to double click to highlight it, get rid of it, type in 3, and hit enter. And I'm going to let you in on another secret. That is it. Like, that's all I have to do. That's a great thing about these, you know, designs from Design Bundles, and specifically this was for my Plus membership. And of course, I thought this was really cute to put on a wine glass because, you know, I spent a whole year homeschooling, and let's just say that I learned a new respect for teaching of all ages. So now I have my Joy selected. I am cutting this on my Joy, which is also super exciting. So I'm gonna click over to Make It. Now in the Make It panel, the first thing it's gonna do is ask me, am I cutting with or without a mat? Now I am gonna cut without a mat because it's super easy. So without a mat, and it'll tell me what material size I need to have. So what I've done is I have cut down a scrap that is 5.5 inches wide so that it will feed into my Cricut Joy perfectly. So amazing. I don't need to mirror. Everything looks good here. So I'm going to click continue. Now what it's going to do is connect to my Cricut Joy. So make sure you have it plugged in and turned on. And then I'm going to choose Smart Vinyl Permanent. Okay. Those settings work really well for me. Pressure default. And then all I need to do is go ahead and load the material into my machine. And then I'm going to come back to the software and click go to start the cutting process. So let's go ahead and head on over and I will show you what that looks like. All right, guys. So here we are. I have the basics, which is our wine glass. And this is our glass etched vinyl. This is in silver. It comes in a couple other different tints, but silver is my favorite. Transfer tape. Now this painter's tape has a hidden meaning, so you'll see more about that in just a minute. Scissors and some weeding tweezers. So my cut file is ready to go. So I'm gonna take my adhesive vinyl here and just feed it straight into my Cricut Joy. Now before we start the actual cutting, let's talk about sizing your design on your wine glass. This is one of my favorite tools. It's just a simple measuring tape. And what I do for every single item that I make, and this is my little hidden tool here, it'll hold my wine glass for me, but I can measure out, okay, 3 inches wide, and then I can measure how tall, which in this case can be up to 3 inches. So up to a 3x3 decal. But what I want to tell you guys most about this is you want to be careful the design that you choose because of how curved wine glasses are. Okay, so there's a lot of room to end up with wrinkled or crooked decals. We're going to talk more about application, but our text designs work best. All right, so let's go ahead and cut our design, and then we will talk about weeding and applying. You hit unload on your computer and it will unload your vinyl. So let's move this out of the way.
Now you can take a pair of scissors and just trim around your design. With a pair of weeding tweezers or whatever weeding tool you have, I go ahead and pierce the top corner and just pull on back, and my design should be left on the backing, okay? Now this is just like regular adhesive vinyl. It weeds to me the same. So then of course you come in with your weeding tweezers and pull out the insides of your letters. Now for your transfer tape, you just need a piece that is going to cover your design. Peel off the transfer tape. There we go, nice and clear. And then because my vinyl is a little bit curved, this was stored on a roll, you can just start from one end, press it down in place, and then smooth it up. Break out your squeegee, give it a nice little burnish. When you peel it back, all of your vinyl is now adhered to your transfer tape. Now let's talk about application. What I'm going to do, now this is text, so you know I have three rows here, and I'm actually gonna trim my transfer tape about an inch into the design, okay? Now I'm very careful not to cut my vinyl, and I'm leaving the middle part adhered. I'm not cutting it all the way apart. Can you see? So what that's going to allow me to do is to take my design, go ahead and line it up at the top. Now, and here's the important part about placement. You don't want to place too far down because the curve gets much more pronounced. So you want to go towards the top, which is fine because typically down here is where your hand is going to be anyway. So line it up at the top. Still try to make sure it's centered. Okay, you can smooth it down the middle to make sure that your overall placement is fine. And then I start with the middle. And then I'll do the top. And all I'm doing is smoothing down each piece individually. The bottom with the curve will be the hardest, okay? So be a little patient with it. And you can also come in after you've removed the transfer tape and make any little modifications that you need. But typically with the little slits that we cut, this should be fine. Now what I'm doing, especially down here at the bottom, I'm being careful not to force this into place, okay? I have a ripple here, and if I force it into place, it's just gonna crease. So I force down, or rather push down the rest of the design, and when I peel off my transfer tape, okay, and what I did was I just left that little bubble there. Let me move this. A black background's gonna work best for you guys. All right, so right here, I have a little bubble. So what I'll do is either with my finger, now I have fingernails, so it's a lot easier for me, but you can use your tweezers too, but I peeled it loose, and then I'll just use my finger to smooth it down. And that's what you're gonna do with any bubbles or ripples that you have. Like I have another one here. So I'm just gonna, here, let me show you with the tweezers. I can just reach under because I didn't force it down into place, pull it up, and slide it down. Okay? And that's why we call it glass etching the easy way, because it is simply as easy as applying your decal. And I have another one for comparison. I want you to really look at them side by side. And honestly, other than the glare of the lights, there we go, you really can't tell the difference, okay? It's not something that you're gonna look at and go, oh man, I bet that's vinyl. It looks amazing. And of course, these are two pretty awesome wine glasses, if I do say so myself. But this is our design for today. Let me give you a closer look. This one is real glass etching. This one is our vinyl glass etching. Now I say glass etching, this is temporary. The vinyl can, in theory, be peeled off, whereas this is permanent, okay? Permanent, technically temporary, but unless you're really rough with your washing, then this should absolutely last you quite a while. But that's it. Like I said, that's exactly how easy it is to do glass etching the easy way. I love it. Love it, love it, love it. It's simple, it's easy, and it's just something that I thoroughly enjoy doing. And because it's a lot easier and semi-temporary, I can actually switch out my sayings as often as I want to. So a little vinyl, a little transfer tape, wine glasses you can get from just about anywhere. I think this was a 4-pack at Walmart for less than $5. And just overall, glass etching, I feel like, makes really great gifts. And you can apply it to glass. It also looks really great on acrylic because you cannot etch glass on normal acrylic, obviously. And then it also works really great on things like mirrors. So you're really unlimited with what you can do on these clear type surfaces. So let's go ahead and wrap it up. So guys, how did you feel about our glass etching the easy way? Now, I know we did not technically etch the glass, but it is the easy way because it is so super easy and quick. I'm telling you, you could size this design, cut it, and have it on the glass in probably 2 to 3 minutes top. Super, super easy. I love it, and I love glass etching in general, so if you're looking for a full tutorial on actual glass etching, we can hook you up with that too. So definitely check out that video on the YouTube channel. You're already in the right place. So guys, if you learned something from the video today, definitely make sure you give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel. I really love all the support that you show for us here so that we can keep bringing you these videos in the future. But I'm going to wrap it up for today. So thanks again for stopping by, and we'll see you again next time.